Hey everybody, my name is Ryan with Spektate. Today I'm going to show you how to get set up with the Spektate Streamer panel. Prediction matches are the bread and butter of how Spektate works, and they allow your viewers to bet points to predict the outcome of your games. Let's start one right now. You can choose from a preset list of questions from all the games that we support. I'm going to select Fortnite. On the viewer side, you'll see that before you start a match, it says waiting for streamer to start the next match. On the streamer side, once you click start, your viewers are now able to enter their questions. On the viewer side, the question set has popped up. Viewers can wager their spectator points on different outcomes that they think may happen during your match. Once they are satisfied with their choices, they can lock in their predictions and they are ready to play the game. On the streamer side, once you have given your users sufficient time to answer the questions, you may lock the predictions in and start the match. At this point, you are free to go off and play your actual Fortnite game. And only once you are finished, you can come back here and report the results of what actually happened. These results will be compared to what the users chose, and they will be awarded points accordingly. By finalizing results, you can see the results of the top three players, and you can see the results of how I did right here. And on the viewer side, you can see the results of my choices. Now let's talk about community goals. Over here on the room details page, down in the section titled goals, this is where you can set up group objectives for your users to pool together their points to accomplish things on stream. So there's a few different ways you can use this. You can see already I have one set up for a gift card giveaway. The users need to pool together 10,000 points, at which point I'll do a raffle on my stream. Let's add a few more. Maybe I'll floss for my viewers. And I want to make this one pretty easy, so we'll say that this one's only a 1,500 point goal. And maybe I'll add one more to do 50 push-ups every time we can reach the goal of, say, 500 points. So we'll save those. On the viewer side, you can see that we're still waiting for the next match to start. And while we're doing that, we can come down here and browse the active goals. Here's my push-up goal, my floss goal, as well as my gift card giveaway, which you'll see is already 1,000 points towards the 10,000 point goal. And since I won a few points during the last match, I think I have a few to spend, so I'll donate some to some of these. We can put a couple hundred points towards the push-up goal. And maybe I will put a couple hundred points towards the floss goal as well.
Spektate has a helpful selection of overlays that you can use on your stream that come installed right out of the box. If you head over to your Editor tab, you're able to add all these overlays in the Sources section. Down here under Apps, you'll see that we have a tutorial, a leaderboard, and then the normal Spektate overlay. The normal Spektate overlay does a few things. It will show users the URL to access your given room. It will post updates when the matches change, start, or end. And it'll also post the names of winners. The Spektate leaderboard overlay will show a list of the top 5 players that are winning points in your group. It's best to use this overlay large on your screen, and you can flip through it when you want to show your users who's doing the best. Finally, the Spektate tutorial overlay is an easy way to flip to this and show your users just how to play the game. It covers the essential topics and should get your users up to speed quickly. This has been a brief overview of Spektate, how to run matches, and how to run community goals. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us on Discord.